Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, children, so today we are having the sixth session of personality development classes. And as you know, we have till now, we have discussed on various aspects of development of our personality. We started from the external aspects, how to dress up, how to speak in public, how to, you can say, carry yourself, how to use the right gestures and postures to have a very powerful impact on the person in front of you. Now we move on to the inner self. Actually, we have to work on the inside. I hope you all realize it's very important because, as I said, appearances are deceptive. If you appeal somebody by your looks, it is going to be a short-term appeal. Very soon, he's going to find out what sort of a person you are. So you have to work on yourself, on your inner traits. And most important among them comes self-confidence. Can anyone define what is self-confidence? Dia, can you define what is self-confidence?
When we believe in ourselves.
Okay, Ashmeel?
Self-confidence is the capability of oneself to trust himself, to say that I am right. I'm not overconfident that only I am right, but having faith, like I am right. And if there is something right going on, so avoid the comments that people are giving and focusing on what you want.
Very good. Ashmeen, have these classes really helped you to build up your self-confidence? Be frank about that.
Yes, ma'am, it's really helpful. Ma'am, really, really, it's helped me a lot. I'm like, I used to be a little shy, but ma'am, I'm very frank with you and ma'am, with other friends as well.
Now you're comfortable in these classes, Ashmeen. I can see the growth in you, really. I can see it in 5 days' time.
Yes, ma'am.
What Ashmeen was on day number one and what Ashmeen is today, there is a remarkable difference. And by the end of these sessions, you are going to really grow up in your personality, beta. I can assure you that. So self-confidence, beta, basically means trust in your own judgment. Whatever decisions you have taken, whatever way you are doing in life, first of all, you should have trust that I am right. If you feel I am doing something wrong, you will never be able to give your 100% to it. If forcefully, let's say in life, you are doing something, others are forcing you to do something, have you realized? You are never able to give your 100%. So self-confidence is a basic necessity. You remember, I'll tell you a fact that earlier what used to happen a few years back, let's say a decade back, parents used to decide what career option the child is going to opt for. Parents used to say, you're going to become a scientist, okay, you're going to become a doctor, you're going to become an engineer. Maybe the child does not want to become an engineer. He wants to become an artist. He wants to become a musician. But children were not given freedom to choose their own career. It was the parents who used to decide. What happened resulting in jobs which did not satisfy the people? Maybe you are working as an engineer somewhere, but where is your mind and your soul and your heart towards drawing, towards your artistic output? So you cannot give your 100% in that. So it should always be. Now, trend has changed. Children are free to choose whatever they want. So many new streams are opening up. I remember when I was in plus two, there were only these three options in life. Either you become a doctor or you become an engineer or you become a lawyer. Children never used to opt for art and humanities or for commerce. It was thought that only those students who are mediocre or below average will go for arts and commerce. Good ones always used to go for science. But I can see now many, many toppers who are taking up humanities stream because they have the confidence they can make it. Whatever stream you choose, you should be very, very confident that you will be able to make your mark in this. Having trust in your own judgment, in your capacity, in your ability, and valuing yourself. In the very first session, I told you one statement, I love myself. You should value yourself. If you are not sure about yourself, you will never be able to, impress others. This is a very important aspect of personality, that we should value ourselves. Then suppose, let's say there are a few drawbacks in us. मेरे अंदर कुछ कमियां हैं, so I can work on it. You have to develop your self-esteem. You have to cope up with whatever is going on in life. You cannot be a loser. Afreen, I hope you are getting it. Seem to be distracted somewhat. And then taking risks in life is also there. If you remember road not taken, the poet took the other road, obviously. Okay, so you have to, at times you might be making mistakes in life. Nobody's life is perfect. Maybe I've taken a wrong decision by choosing this particular stream. But was my own decision. So after making this wrong decision, you will learn a lot and you are going to improve on it. Doing what you think is right, leaving your comfort zone. कई बार क्या होता है बेटा, हम अपने comfort zone में इतने comfortable है ना, I don't want to move out of it. मुझे लग रहा है कि मैं सिर्फ एक टीचर बन के रह के छोटी ये क्लासेस को पढ़ा के मैं बहुत कंफर्टेबल हूँ. इफ आई प्लान फॉर एन अकेडमी ऑफ माइन, आई विल हैव टू डू अ लॉट ऑफ हार्ड वर्क. मुझे इस लिमिटेड इस कंफर्ट जोन से बाहर निकलना पड़ेगा. आई विल हैव टू वर्क हार्ड ऑन इट. कई बार इंसान क्या सोचता है, रहने दे यार, ठीक है, वॉट एवर इज गोइंग ऑन इज फाइन. यू अवॉइड टेकिंग न्यू रिस्क, यू आर स्केयर्ड ऑफ द फ्यूचर ऑफ द आउटकम्स. बट सच अ पर्सन कैन नेवर ग्रो. ग्रोथ किसमें है? At times you have to take risk, calculated risk, but I would say these are calculated risks. You have to take certain risks in life, leave your comfort zone and try and opt for new things. And then again, the way you speak, the nervous, fumbling person is never like. Suppose you go, let's say you meet somebody, you want to be friends with him. और आप जब आप उससे बात करना शुरू करते हो, आप देखते हो बार-बार fumble कर रहा है, clearly नहीं बोल पा रहा है, अपने आप को express नहीं कर पा रहा है. Will you want to be friends with him? I don't think. Everyone wants a confident person, जिसकी speech clear है, जो आपको समझ में आ रहा है. Again, then building these confident habits, that is physical and mental health, both are equally important. Physically आप fit हो, mentally भी fit होने चाहिए हो. Have a positive image of yourself. It's very important. और इसके लिए बेटा हम एक बहुत अच्छी strategy आपको बताऊँ, that is setting goals. How do we set goals? सीधा ये नहीं कि मैंने IAS officer बनना है. I'm talking about small, short-term goals. छोटे छोटे गोल्स लाइफ में सेट करके लेटर ऑन वी कैन अचीव द हायर गोल्स. कैन यू गिव मी एन एग्जांपल, एनी वन ऑफ यू, अबाउट दिस? जस्ट करण, व्हाट डू यू से? हैव यू एवर ट्राइड दिस?
मैम, आई कैन नॉट गिव द एग्जांपल, बट आई कैन ऐड अप ऑन इट दैट इफ वी हैव द गुड गोल्स, सो द बेसिक थिंग वी नीड दैट वी शुड एंजॉय द लिटिल अचीवमेंट्स. इफ वी विल एंजॉय आवर लिटिल अचीवमेंट्स, वी विल गेट द गुड एनकरेजमेंट towards our goal, good settlement towards the goal, through which we can get the good positivity and we can attain that goal. Sometimes na, we people think that ki, when we get the small achievement, hum kehte hain ki haan, bahut choti si hai, koi baat nahi hota rahega. But right, we should right. enjoy that point. We should enjoy that moment. We should give the satisfaction to our heart that we are working upon it.
Very nice. Very nice. This is what I really wanted to emphasize, beta. छोटी छोटी बातों पे हम खुशियां नहीं ढूंढते हैं, हम बड़ी खुशियां ढूंढ रहे हैं लाइफ में. विच माइट बी देयर इन द स्मॉल थिंग्स, द स्मॉल गोल्स यू अचीव. लेट्स से अगेन गिविंग यू एन एग्जांपल, एक आईएएस ऑफिसर बनना इज लेट्स से समवॉट 5 इयर्स 7 इयर्स आफ्टर टुडे यू आर गोइंग टू बिकम. एक छोटा सा गोल अचीव करना, लेट्स से क्लास प्लस वन में आई वॉज डिक्लेयर्ड द बेस्ट स्टूडेंट ऑफ द ईयर और द मोस्ट रिस्पॉन्सिबल स्टूडेंट. अब छोटा सा गोल ना, स्मॉल गोल, बट इट शुड मेक यू हैप्पी. यू आर प्रोग्रेसिंग, चल तो पड़े हो रास्ते पे, पहुंच जाओगे मंजिल पे. So achieving these small goals in life, always set small goals for yourself first. Ek bahut bade high aim ko agar aap karoge to it will become difficult. Start with one step at a time. That is what is required. Yes, Yash, what do you say?
Yes, ma'am, I totally.
Yes.
Sure, Navdeep.
Like, ma'am, I am a sports person and I'm not thinking of like higher goals, like I want to be an international player. So I set the goal like I will break the state record, then I will focus on the national medal, then I will think of internationals. Like I've put my goals there, that I will break my state record.
That's really wonderful. Can you show us what is that, Navreet?
Yes.
I would love to see. Your wall seems beautifully decorated. So you put your goals there.
Yes.
Which game do you play now?
Favorite players, Olympic players.
Oh, wow. Wonderful. I love this idea of yours, Navdeep. See, we learn something from everyone. Really impressed, Navdeep. Very good. I must say. Jasnoor, you want to add on to it?
Ma'am, I would like to say something.
Okay, Yash, yes.
Ma'am, to summarize Jaskaran's and Navreet's idea and your idea included, I can say that with gradual improvement, we can definitely succeed. Because being happy on little things can make us like give us the motivation to work on the bigger goal, and then we can definitely work upon succeeding, and the way we can find the path to success.
Truly said, Yash, I agree. This is what most of us miss out on. Manat, want to say something?
Mom, I want to say something, Mom, but it is in Hindi.
Okay, please. We don't mind, Manat.
Yes? कहते हैं मैम कि एकदम मैम छोटी छोटी खुशियों में हमें ज्यादा खुशियां मिलती है, अगर हम एक साथ इकट्ठी खुशियां ले लें तो मैम उसमें इतना मजा नहीं आता, हम छोटी छोटी करके मजा आता
है. स्वीट, सो स्वीट, वेल एक्सप्रेस्ड मदर, रियली वेल.
थैंक यू मैम.
बिल्कुल सही बात कही है बेटा आपने कि हमें छोटी खुशियों में खुशियां ढूंढना आना चाहिए, एंड मोस्ट ऑफ अस हम नहीं ढूंढते बेटा. अगेन ह्यूमन नेचर, हम बड़ी बड़ी गोल्स को टारगेट करते हैं, हम सोचते हैं आज से 5 साल बाद जब मैं एक आईएएस ऑफिसर बन जाऊंगी तब मैं खुश होंगी. हु नोज व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन आफ्टर 5 years? नोबडी नोज. यू कांट इवन प्रिडिक्ट व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन आफ्टर द नेक्स्ट 5 minutes. हाउ कैन यू प्रिडिक्ट फॉर द 5 years? एंड लाइफ इज टू अनप्रिडिक्टेबल दीज डेज. आपको कल नहीं पता क्या हो जाएगा, तो प्लीज व्हाट यू हैव अचीव टुडे एटलीस्ट उसको एंजॉय करो. आई एम नॉट सेइंग दैट स्टॉप लुकिंग एट द फ्यूचर. I like the way Navreet has planned her future. But yes, us future ke aane se pehle don't spoil your present. Enjoy the present. That is a personality. You know, a troubled, a nervous person is one who keeps on thinking about the future. As I told you, this is a very big problem with me also. To tell you very frankly, since we've become so close to each other, I always keep on thinking about the future. And then I realize, ki, why am I not enjoying the present moment? This is also going to become past someday. कल को ये भी पास हो जाएगा ना. आई विल रिमेम्बर, वाओ यार 11 टू 12 आई यूज्ड टू हैव अ वंडरफुल सेशन विद दोस किड्स. इफ आई डू नॉट एंजॉय नाउ एट दिस प्रेजेंट मोमेंट, आई विल नेवर लर्न टू यू नो बी हैप्पी इन माय लाइफ. ऑलवेज एंजॉय योर प्रेजेंट. दैट इज व्हाट फॉर्म्स योर पर्सनालिटी. अ स्ट्रांग पर्सनालिटी, अ पर्सन हु नोज आज को जी लो जिसे कहते हैं, दैट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. गुरमन, यू वॉन्ट टू टेल समथिंग? वॉन्ट टू एड ऑन टू समथिंग बेटा?
Ma'am, not that much, as everything is said, that we should first concentrate on these small things, like they give us happiness. So then only we can think that yes, those we can have a set, we can set high goals that can give us happiness. Like if I say that I want to be an IAS.
Okay.
Officer, I can't say that yes, after 5 years I'll definitely be, but first I have to see the earlier obstacles, I have to face them, then I'll I think get happiness from them, that things if I pass them like the way they have to be passed, so I think then I can go in the future and I can tackle those things.
Very good, very good. This is the right path. Actually this is the right way, enjoying small things in life, small success in life, and then aiming on to higher one. Isn't it? We have two more Jaskarans here. Can you show me your face? 3 Jaskarans are meeting. Jaskaran from 10th G and Jaskaran from 10th H. Beta, do you want to add any personal experience to this? I would love to hear that. Any personal experience you had when you really felt happy at something which you gained in life? Any one of you, Chalo, in fact. Some are very shy.
And I?
Yes. Yes, 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 sure. Let's have more of interaction because my lectures will keep on running. I'll never fall short of words. I want you people to interact. Who's going to speak now? We had somebody volunteer.
Ashmeen can.
Ashmeen. Okay, Ashmeen, yes.
Yes, ma'am. Actually, my mom, like my mother, was a great speaker. Ma'am, she used to take part in every declamation. So, ma'am, in her school time as well as college time. Ma'am, and so she wanted to build the self-confidence in me as well. So ma'am, from the playways, she started building the confidence in me and helped me to take part in different competitions. Ma'am, so she set me small goals, like in nursery, you have to do a little poem. Ma'am, like this we have done. Ma'am, so I started taking part in that, ma'am, and then I took part in many inter-house competitions, then in inter-schools. Ma'am, and slowly and steadily, I had won the many
prizes. That confidence built up. See, if your mama had thought, ki straight away my girl is going to go to a national level competition, debate competition and win it, that is impossible. Impossible. Yes. You have to set small goals. She told you that you have to win a poetry recitation competition in nursery class. Then maybe move on to a higher goal. When you go to class two, now you have to participate in an inter-class quiz. Then in an inter-house quiz. Then in an inter-school quiz. You understand? Yes. One step at a time. It's always like this, beta. If you try to jump these steps and reach to the top of the ladder, you will certainly fall down with a big bang. So yes. One step at a time, that is required. Somebody else here wanted to say, I just missed out the name.
Ma'am, are we still talking about self-confidence and being happy over little things and then succeeding in the bigger one?
Yes, yes.
Ma'am, so may I share my experience?
Sure, yes. Always welcome.
And so I want to talk about my book when I first started writing. So ma'am, okay. First of all, it starts from like the exams in the school. I wrote the story. Like I misunderstood that the question for writing the story is above and but it was below. And I thought that the question for the story writing was the one that was in the message writing. So it was kind of messed up and I wasn't able to think a lot, but I wrote the story. And okay. I wrote the story, entire story, and I forgot to make the paragraphs. The teacher, I will not name the teacher though. The teacher crossed out the entire story, gave me 0 marks.
Oh my God.
So, ma'am, then from that time.
Yes, I feel that motivated you.
Yes, ma'am, that did. So from that time, I decided that I'll get something done. To prove myself that I am something. So from that time, last year in October or maybe in the lockdown period, I started writing. I wrote a really short story. I was happy that I did write at least 1,000 words.
Okay.
So then I progressed to 2,000, then 4,000, and the 4,000 word story was my first, the shortest one. And I published it right away without editing. So there were a lot of mistakes, but still it was out there. Now maybe I have uploaded the correct one. So all the points at which I wrote, like I progressed from 1,000 to 2,000 to 3,000 and 4,000. Then I wrote my other two. I felt really happy.
I agree, Yash. Actually, the progress is gradual. Has to be gradual, you know. That is the correct way. If you progress gradually, beta, you will learn a lot of things in that process also. Like Yash said, his first publication had a lot of errors. But next time when he's going to publish, obviously he's going to root out all those errors. So we learn at every step. And this is what builds his confidence. Why do you think he speaks so confidently among us? We see that Yash is very confident. I hope all of you agree with this. Why is he so confident? Have you ever thought about this? He's also of your age. He also has the same childhood as you because he had this, maybe this experience in life which made him resolve to do something. Jab ma'am ne 0 marks de diye, usne kya socha? Ab to I have to get even, hai na? Mujhe to kuch to karna padega. I have to prove myself. So he started writing stories. These small instances in life motivate you. If you remember in one of my sessions, I had said, jo life mein bure incidents hote hai na, they motivate you, they make you stronger. Achhi baatein aapko strong nahi banati hain. The, you can say, unhappy moments of life, the tragedies of life, they make you stronger. It was a big tragedy for Yash, getting a 0 out of a, let's say, 8-mark question. For an intelligent child, it is a tragedy. But then he, you can say, worked upon it and he tried to prove that he is right, which he certainly... Yes, children. Sorry for the slight interruption. The light has gone and we are working on the mobile net now. So, yes. Anyone who wants to add on to it, beta?
May I?
My reason? Yes, yes. We are learning from each.
I want to add upon the necessity of the self-confidence. I want to share that we are in the schooling level right now. We have the competitions within the school. If we go beyond the school, we have very much tough competition. Neck-to-neck competition is there. We have the intelligent students. Most of the we have intelligent students. We have the people, children with the 90%, 98%. If we have many students with the same percentage, how the higher authorities will the judge to whom to select or to not? And then where it is a personality game, that who has a better personality, better confidence, better positive attitude, he should, the higher authorities will accept them. So I want to tell that what is the necessity of the confidence in ourselves. So we should keep our spirits high, that if we are equally also in the group, so we should be selected from that group.
Yes. Means, beta, actually at times, kuch baat life mein aise situations aati hain where you have to prove yourself. Apne aap ko prove karna padta hai. Nobody will understand those unspoken words. You have to prove yourself. Aapko apni capability prove karni padti hai. And you know there is this next cutthroat competition. Hai na? Aajkal to cutthroat competition. Every child is getting above 90. If there are 100 children, usme se I think 80 se upar ke 90% honge hi honge. You know that. Because the pattern of education has changed so much. So I never ever emphasize on an academic excellence. Although I will always say it is required. You should be good academically. But ab agar sare 90% wale ek line mein khade hain, 10 bache. Mujhe ek student choose karna hai. What is going to be my criteria then? Ravneet, what do you say? What should be my criteria? I have to pick up one child I have to take for an international competition. All are above 90. What should be my criteria then?
Ma'am, at that time you will be focusing more upon the personality of a
child
and the confidence of a person. If a person is confident, but he's not getting full marks, or like he is getting average marks, then you will definitely choose that person because of his confidence. But if a person is getting above 90 or 95% and he's not confident, he cannot speak much like confidently in public, so you won't be taking him
I'll be choosing a more confident person who's able to deliver himself
also,
in a better way.
You can also choose on the basis of the practical knowledge. In the today's world, the practical knowledge is also as important as the academic knowledge. So if the topics like confidence, attitude, we do not read in that books, and we cannot understand also with books. So we should have some practical experience and practical knowledge to understand these things and feel these things.
I agree. Awesome. I completely agree.
Also, ma'am, it also depends upon the situation, or like what basis the competition are you sending him, wherever you're sending him for whatever competition, what that competition is for. Is it to represent the school, or is it to represent the person, or is it to just jot down things on the paper and get the marks?
Very good. That is where actually the judgment of the teacher comes in. If it is an academic competition, a quiz competition, certainly my basis for choosing the child are going to be different. My criteria is going to be completely different. Isn't it? If it's a sports competition, I will pick up Navreet, obviously. If it's a debate, I will pick up Yash. Everyone has their own quality, beta. Or I will pick up Jaskaran, in fact, who's very good at debating. Isn't it? If it's a competition where two people have to argue with each other, then I will pick up Afreen. Isn't it? She can argue very, that is also quality, beta. She doesn't feel shy. She can argue and she wants to prove her point right. So depending on the situation, I'm going to pick up the person. What sort of a competition is it? Maybe requires your personality, your speaking skills. Maybe requires your academic skills. Maybe it's an essay writing competition. Then I don't need anyone who has got confidence to speak up. Samajh rahe ho? Phir mujhe wo bachcha chahiye jo achha likh sakta hai. Express कर सकता है और लिख सकता है अच्छा. Who has a good vocabulary? फिर what will I do with the confidence? Maybe I'll pick up Gurman then. If she has a good vocabulary, it all depends on the situation. So you have to develop yourself in the sphere in which you are best. Work upon those things. अपना बेस्ट जो है बेटा आपने उसको, और जिसे कहते हैं ना बेस्ट का कोई सुपरलेटिव डिग्री तो नहीं होता है, आई विल नॉट से बेस्टेस्ट, बट आपने अपने बेस्ट को भी और ज्यादा अच्छा करना है, जस्ट टू प्रूव योर वर्थ अमंग ऑल द पीपल, दिस इज रियली रिक्वायर्ड. सान्या, कैन आई सी यू बेटा? वेयर आर यू सान्या? नॉट विजिबल टू मी.